Hello guys, in this video I will show you how to make a very simple 3D game from scratch in Python, using the ray casting technique. This technique was widely used in the early days of 3D PC games. It consists of launching rays from the player and recording when those rays hit an object. With the distance between the player and the object, an apparent size of the object is defined based on perspective, where closer objects seem to be bigger than the ones that are farther away. So let's get started with the programming. I will use here three libraries for this project: NumPy, Matplotlib and Keyboard. Before anything else, I will define a map for the game with a list of lists, where ones represent walls and zeros represent corridors. This will be a simplistic map with walls all around it and a single block in the middle. Then I will define the starting position for the player with X and Y coordinates, and do the same for the exit. I will also define an initial rotation for the player that indicates where he's looking at. Now we can start the vision loop to draw the player's perspective with a field of view of 60 degrees. In each iteration I will vary the viewing angle, starting from 30 degrees to the right until reaching 30 degrees to the left. For each new angle, the ray will start at the player's position and then, in a ray loop, it is incremented until hitting a wall. This increment has to be relatively small, otherwise the ray can pass straight through some corners. To find out if a ray hit a wall, we check the integer part of the ray coordinates and verify if it's equal to a wall location on the map. Every time it finds a wall, a height will be calculated as the inverse of the distance. This height is used to draw a vertical line on the screen. Now we can take a look at how the player's vision looks like. You can see the center wall block in the middle. If everything is fine, we can put the vision loop inside a new loop. This will be the main game loop. We take this opportunity to make some adjustments to the plotting lines. Increase the thickness of the vertical lines, disable the graph axis, activate the tight layout to remove blank spaces, limit the plot region, replace the show by the draw function, which is more suitable for the iterative plotting. Between plots there needs to be a short pause, and then the old plot data should be cleared. I will also make the window close automatically when the main loop is exited. After we are all set, we can enable the player's movement, using the function readKey to read the key that's being pressed. First, I will make a copy of the player's position. To move forwards or backwards, I've chosen the up and down arrows, and for rotation, the left and right arrows. The player is only allowed to move if the new position is not a wall. When he reaches the exit, the game is over, and if the S key is pressed, the game is interrupted. At this point, we have a more or less functioning game, but this black and white visual is not very pleasing. So let's make some improvements to the game graphics. In a new loop, I will go through all the map positions, and every time I find a wall, I will replace the number 1 with a random color. The colors are defined by 3 random numbers, ranging from 0 to 1, which are RGB components. Now returning to the vision loop, we have to limit the height to be at most equal to 1, so it can be used for shading. The color is retrieved every time a ray hits a wall, then multiplied by a shading factor that depends on the distance between the wall and the player. After that, we just need to activate the colors parameter inside the V-lines plotting. And here's the result, a colorful maze. Now we will take care of the background. First we will put a gray background color for the floor and a blue background for the ceiling. Then initialize 3 vectors for the X and Y coordinates of the tiling and 1 for color. Inside the ray loop we have to always store the last ray position to compare it with the current position. Every time there's a difference between the integer parts, we keep the coordinates. Here I multiplied them by 3 to increase the density of the tiling. To make the exit easier to find, we're gonna paint its tiles a different color. Finally, we have a game like this, much more pleasing visually. But something very important is still missing. The current game map is no challenge to anyone. We could make use of some better preconceived maps, but I thought it would be more interesting to create a random map generator. So every time anyone plays, it is effectively a different game. I will start with a simple generator. First, we define the size of the map and create a matrix filled with walls. After that, we randomly choose a starting position and make a random walker. In each new position, it will remove the walls of the map, and when it arrives on the other side, it stops and marks the last position as the exit of the maze. This results in very simple maps, hard to call them mazes, because the exit can be seen from far away. So we will make an enhanced version. In the same way as previously, we start by defining the map size and filling it with walls, which here is done in a single line. Then inside the loop we randomly remove 2/3 of the inner walls. The random walker works in a similar way, but it will give preference to routes that do not remove new walls. It will only remove a wall after trying to move 6 times with no success. And there we have much more interesting maps, where the player can actually get lost. And that's the final result, a nicely done 3D maze game. Very simple and easy to understand. Hope you enjoyed, thanks for watching, and until the next time.